Welcome everyone to Burnaby Mountain and the campus of Simon Fraser University in Burnaby. We are just about set for the first game of the final day here at the GNAC CCAA Challenge. The game we have for you coming up, the Western Washington Vikings and the Cal State Dominguez Hills Toros from California. Thank you again for joining us here as we start the 2022-23 NCAA men's basketball season here in Burnaby and, of course, across North America. In gyms all across the continent, we have the Vikings here in blue and the Toros here in their white jerseys with maroon lettering. On the court for Western Washington to start the game, we have Johnson, Hornbuckle, Minnis, Ned and Colley, and for Cal State Dominguez Hills, Hillstock, Cheatham, Ball, Miller, and Seymour. And it is the Vikings with the first touch of the ball. Ball inside, then back out to the top of the circle. Three-point shot is good from Jonathan Ned as he opens the scoring here for Western Washington. Now the Toros have the ball into the corner. Shot clock down to 15. Spin move, jump shot from Seymour is no good. Rebound taken by Minnis. Now into the corner, the ball is loose on the floor. Colley recovering. Ball worked around to the wing, Hornbuckle inside. And then now back to the sideline. Worked into the wing, Johnson for three, no good. Rebound fought for down at the baseline, and it will be a foul call against Cal State Dominguez Hills. And for those of you interested as viewers from Western Washington, thought I'd just get this score in from women's soccer. They defeated Point Loma 1-0 today in their NCAA tournament game, as we just got the email in from their esteemed SID, Jeff Evans. So good news for the Vikings as we get a foul now, an offensive foul against Western Washington. That is going to be a foul, an offensive foul on the Vikings, and the ball turned over to Cal State Dominguez Hills. Colley called for the infraction, his first. On the drive, inside, high looping shot that's just off the target from Miller, but the ball bouncing back into the hands of Ball. Fed inside. And from the middle of the paint, jumper no good from Cheatham. And down the other way is Ned. Hornbuckle getting instructions here. Defensively for the Toros. Minnis work back out to the wing. Hornbuckle for three, and it's good. And the Vikings off to a quick 6-0 lead here. About 2 minutes gone in this first half of the GNAC CCAA Challenge game between Western Washington and Cal State Dominguez Hills. That three-point shot off target from Hillstock, as the ball bounces out of bounds for possession for the Vikings. Johnson. Colley looking to find room. Right side drive off the glass. Good for two. The first 2-point field goal in this game for the Vikings, as they are quickly up 8-0 here against the Toros. And now the bounce pass kicked out of bounds. Ball will put the ball back into play and finds his teammate Miller. Miller going to his left, pass to his left, baseline fake, then drive for two. Seymour gets CSU Dominguez Hills on the board. Now Minnis trying to respond here for Western Washington. 3 minutes into this game. Cauley going inside, loses the ball, gets control back, and then puts the shot up and down for another 2 points. Great control there inside as Cauley recovers and converts. Three-pointer on the way, no good. And rebound controlled by CSU Dominguez Hills. Miller. Ball has it stripped, but I believe they're going to call a foul on Jonathan Ned. Ball back into play for the Toros. They're down 10-2 early here. Ball down to Cheatham. Looking to spin against Johnson. The two number ones battling, and it will be Cheatham stepping on the end line and turning the ball back over to the Vikings. Some going one-on-one action here in the backcourt. Western Washington. Johnson, scoop layup, blocked out of bounds. And just trying to see the player there. It's Seymour, I believe, with the block. Last night, Western Washington defeated Humboldt State in a real high-tempo game. And then in a much slower tempo game, Cal State Dominguez Hills defeated SFU 66-63 as the ball goes out of bounds. Returning possession to the Toros. Miller trying to find a teammate in the corner. I believe that's Howard. Pardon me, no, that's Cameron Berry, newly into the game. Junior college transfer from San Diego Miramar College. Three-pointer on the way. That is going to be a two-pointer on the way. That's Berry, the man we were just talking about. And it's 10-4 for Western Washington. Minnis, pull-up jumper, no good, rebound taken by CSU Dominguez Hills. That's Seymour with the rebound. Now a quick three on the way. That time it will be a three, and it's Berry again. And that will put us into a timeout. 15:29 on the clock. And it's going to be a media timeout, so we're going to send it to a break with Western Washington ahead 10-7. Back in action here at the West Gym on top of Burnaby Mountain on the campus of Simon Fraser University. Game 3 of the GNAC CCAA Challenge That's Western Washington ahead 10-7 over Cal State Dominguez Hills. Now make it 13-7 on that three-pointer from just in front of the Western Washington bench from Jonathan Ned. Jumper on the way, left side, just outside right, no good from Seymour. And the Vikings looking to push the pace here. And the lay-in, no good. And Dominguez Hills will come back down the floor. 13-7, they trail by six. Long two on the way, and straight down for Andre Ball. Makes it a 13-9 game as we are early, of course, in this first half. Johnson, spin move, little off-balance jumper. Nice play by Western Washington's number one, the 6'4 sophomore out of Olympia, the state capital. Ball fed inside, and Ball converts. The 6'8 junior gets his team back within four at 15-11. He's also, of course, a transfer from Division I Pepperdine, and then gets the rebound off that Vikings miss, and it's back down the floor for Cameron Berry. Berry into the baseline, to the hoop, and it's a dunk for Seymour, and he gets his team to within 2 points, 15-13. Minnis for the Vikings with possession, looking to go all the way to the hoop, pass back out, intercepted by Hillstock. And he doesn't have numbers, so he'll pull back to Berry. Swung around now to Miller. Hillstock getting the ball back, getting some space, and getting 3 points on the board to put his team in the lead, 16-15. So Johnson trying to reply here for the team in blue. Johnson to the hoop, this time a bit strong, grabs his own rebound. And now back out to Hornbuckle, wearing number three for the Vikings, getting a screen. Stepping back, jumper is good, a long two. Very impressive shooting from quite a few guys on the floor here as he puts Western Washington back up 17-16. Hillstock, strong rebound to number one, Johnson. Johnson finding room all the way to the baseline. Back out to the wing. Minnis will slow the play down here in this half-court set for the Vikings. Over to Hornbuckle. Johnson cutting to the hoop. And that is going to be a nice lay-in for two. A stoppage in play here as Dominguez Hills will call a timeout. As Steve Becker, the head coach, will call a timeout for the Toros in his ninth season at the helm of this program. Graduate of Cal State Monterey Bay. On the other end, the coaching staff of Western Washington is led by Tony Dominguez in his 11th season. Thank you for joining us here on Red Leafs TV as we provide you coverage of the GNAC CCAA Challenge. And the score here with 12:05 to go in the first half, it's 19-16 for Western Washington. And just excuse me here as I'm sitting right in front of the printer, so we're trying to make sure it survives the night here. Play back underway. Cal State Dominguez Hills down by three, but with the ball here. And now an illegal screen on the Toros. Low called for the illegal screen. And so we will have Western Washington with possession of the ball. Hornbuckle now handing off to Johnson. Johnson, very aggressive to the hoop. The miss, but the rebound put back made by Nick Welp, who had 9 points last night against Cal Poly Humboldt. Ball, foul line, turnaround, jumper short. Welp with the rebound. And quickly to Johnson, up the floor. It's ball, it's a Hornbuckle. Being guarded by Isaiah Morris. And Morris dives on the floor and knocks the ball back behind the timeline, out of bounds. Stays Western Washington possession. And we will get play back underway. It is Welp handing off. Mays the jumper. And looks like it's going to be Morris with the rebound. A 3-on-2 break, maybe. Ball tipped away. And it is Western Washington down the floor and an easy transition layup for Matthew Mays, sophomore transfer from West Los Angeles College. Step back jumper, strong from Cheatham. And one shot and done here for the Toros as they find themselves back down by 7, 23-16. They did take the lead here by one earlier in the half. Ball fed inside, the jumper short though from Mays. He found himself just in front of three Toros defenders, not a lot of room. Ball inside and the layup just strong from Lowe. Three ball on the way from number three of Western Washington. Hornbuckle does not go. Back the other way, it's a 2-point fast break lay-in. Jeremy Dent Smith. And now the play is stopped to reset or to finesse the shot clock. Should be 28. So now Eric Watson in for the Toros and Minnis back in for Western Washington. And now foul just on the sideline, no shot. Ball back in, Johnson getting contact. I think he wanted the and one as well, but he scores the bucket to make it 25-18 for Western Washington. Toros can't convert there on that shot from Watson. Hornbuckle handing off to Welp. Back to Hornbuckle. Baseline jumper just strong there. And we will have the Toros. Can't really get in transition there as Western Washington had three guys back, but the off-balance leaner from Cheatham goes from the short corner. Dominguez Hills back within two possessions. Couple of spin moves, and it will be Lucas Holden drawing the foul. And impressive for the senior to stay patient in the paint and get that opportunity from the line. And the first foul shot from Holden goes down. And then a couple more subs come in for Dominguez Hills. And second shot is good as well. So we've got a 27-20 game here in favor of the Western Washington Vikings. They are, of course, one of the main rivals of the host school here, Simon Fraser. That turnaround shot off the backboard does not go, and then the rebound knocked out of bounds. And unfortunately for the Toros, they again will be forced to play defense after missing their lone shot of the possession. Johnson, isolated, down low, back up, Welp, open for three, and he's got it. And I don't think you can leave very many of these Vikings open with that type of space, as they will make you pay that time. A triple from the top of the circle. The Toros trying to probe the defense here. Pass out to the wing, three ball from ball, and it will be a triple in response for the Toros. Quickly down the floor, it's Welp, looked at a three, then in the foul line for Colley, and then cross to Minnis. Welp, one dribble, then hands off to Johnson. Johnson throws it back towards center, and it will go back for a violation. And then we will have a media timeout. So we're going to take a break here as well here on Red Leafs TV. Thank you for joining us. The score, 30-23 for Western Washington with 6:55 to go.
Dear College Sports.
There's light at the end of the tunnel.
A return to normal and all we love about sports.
You've instilled resilience, focus, and selflessness in us. We've put those lessons to work.
We've found strength and unity in each other.
You continue to take us places we never imagined.
You bring out the best in us.
So when we look forward, we see the light at the end of the tunnel.
We see a better world for all of us.
And for College Sports.
We are back underway here at the West Gym. This GNAC CCA challenge game between Western Washington and Cal State Dominguez Hills. And that time, a triple attempt from the top of the circle just off the mark by Ball. And so the team rebound going to Western Washington, and the Vikings will now set up in the half court offense here as they look to add to their 30-23 lead. Colley trying to find room, trying to create room, and it will be a baseline foul against Cal State Dominguez Hills. Ball lobbed back into play for Colley. Defense! ball back into the paint, and I believe that's going to be another infraction on the Toros. Western Washington, 16 on the shot clock. Holden, ball controlled by Western. And the three-point shot no good from Ned. And I believe the ball went out of bounds. The team rebound going to the Toros. And again, in the middle of the play, looks like it's Velp for Western. Vikings with control here. Colley draws the foul. And the Toros very animated in showing their displeasure around that call. Think Cal State Dominguez Hills coach Eric Becker having an issue with the official furthest away from the play making the call there. But nonetheless, the foul will send Colley to the line for two shots. He misses his first. And will now get set for his second. Oh, 6 minutes to go before halftime, as we have a 31-23 difference between these two teams. Western Washington in the lead. Cal State Dominguez Hills with the ball. And a three ball launched from an open space on the right side, but off the mark there from Hillstock. And we have Minnis back out to Velp. And his three ball again. I believe that's his second of the game. And now Western Washington quickly back up by double digits, 34-23. And the Toros can't respond with a three of their own. Now on the rebound. And in transition, pull-up three for Minnis, no good. Loose ball taken by Watson. And then now Morris. Dent Smith going inside the scoop lay-in, does not go. And then now a loose ball foul against Cal State Dominguez Hills. So more subs coming in for the Toros as well as the Vikings, as the last foul, the eighth of the half for CSU Dominguez Hills, will send Colley to the line. And first shot is good. On the floor for Western Washington, you got Hornbuckle, Minnis, Colley, Jonathan Ned, and Velp. As Colley looks at his second shot, that one rattles in and makes it 35-23. On the floor for Cal State Dominguez Hills, you've got Miller with the ball right now. You've got Hillstock and ball, and then up front, you've got Watson on the floor as well as Barry. Ball going inside. Watson, turnaround shot, nicely done as he gets the Toros back on the board here, down by 11, 4:44 to go before halftime in this non-conference tournament game between these Western rivals. Pass intended for Velp off the netting, and then now in transition, a big block there by Western Washington, and the stuff going to Colley. Possession though staying with the Toros. Team rebound going to CSU Dominguez Hills. And now ball back into play. Face up to the bucket. Ball leaning in and getting that hook shot to go. So a couple of better possessions offensively for CSU Dominguez Hills, and they are back within 9 points. And they got the first part of a defensive stop, but they couldn't get the rebound, and so the Vikings will get another few seconds on this possession. 12 on the shot clock, 4 left in the first half. Minnis Stepping back, then across, knocked away. Hillstock to the hoop, and just strong. The tip is no good. And then the ball corralled by Western Washington. Hornbuckle now will slow the pace down. 3:40 to go in this first half. Jumper from the wing. That one was a three-point attempt. And Miller for CSU Dominguez Hills will get the ball over to Hillstock. Ball on the drive, trying to get between two players, and he will draw the foul. Cauley leaning in for another block. And called for the foul, so we will take a break as well. 3:18 to go on the clock, 36-27 for Western Washington.
I'm here to make a difference.
I'm here to create.
To innovate.
To do research that matters.
I am here to continue asking questions.
To continue learning.
To expand my horizons.
I am here to grow.
Back in the West Gym with the first foul shot. First of two here. And the trip ends up four. Andre Ball is a 1-for-2 adventure at the foul line. 36-28 still in favor of the Vikings. Inside feed, Johnson has it knocked away, and now to the hoop, the lay-in transition and the foul. Damian Miller gets two and an opportunity for a third. So Miller will go to the line, completes the old-fashioned three-point play, and we are again within two possessions here. 36-31. And now the ball turned over by Western. Cal State Dominguez Hills back down the floor. Ball, ooh, almost lost possession himself. Miller, I think, will settle things down here, looking to his left. It's Barry. Hillstock falling, but getting the ball to Ball. And now going inside, jump stop, pass back out, intercepted by Western Washington. And it's going to be Johnson, 1-on-2, no good. The putback, no good from Holden, but he will draw the foul. And both teams, I think, a little bit upset about missed opportunities. But great play by Holden to get to the end of that ball, anticipating and not assuming that that ball was going to drop, and he was right there on the spot. And he will now earn a trip to the foul line.
Yeah.
And it's 38-31 after those two shots. And the three-point shot makes it a 38-34 game for Western Washington. They have the ball, they have the lead, but Dominguez Hill's coming on. Holden, top of the circle, three ball, strong. The putback no good, second putback no good, and it will be a foul on the rebound. Ned at the line for Western Washington, wearing number 13. Off, rebound, Velp, and a new possession for the Vikings. Velp at the top of the circle, trying to find a teammate, lobs it into Ned. Two on the shot clock, turn around, and he's going to draw the foul. On that turnaround, Lehner going backwards. I believe that came with one or two on the shot clock, and that did not please anyone on the CSU Dominguez Hills bench, because that's basically right where it happened, in front of the Toros bench. And head coach Eric Becker having a chat with one of the officials right now as the foul shot from Ned goes down. The foul called on Miller as he now has to check off his second foul of this half. Second shot off the front rim, off the backboard, and through. Also wanted to give you an update on women's basketball for CSU Dominguez Hills. They lead at Concordia 69-40, Concordia Irvine. As that jumper good from Miller. Pardon me, that was Cheatham, it looks like. Jumper from just behind the foul line goes down for Hornbuckle. It's 43-36. Berry, three-point attempt from the wing, hits the side rim, and the rebound knocked away and loose. As we approach the final half minute of this first half, 43-36 in favor of Western Washington. The Vikings, I think, will settle for one last possession. The shot clock is off. And to the hoop, Minnis, acrobatic drive, but can't get the shot to go. 3 seconds left, 2 seconds left, a buzzer beater attempt, rattles in and out from Cheatham. And so with that, we will have a halftime score, 43-36 in favor of Western Washington. And we're going to take a break here, about a 15-minute break, as we will let you get some refreshments and then come back for the second half between Western Washington and Cal State Dominguez Hills.
Up north, the elements shape us. And like those elements, we are powerful, strong, resilient. Our red leaf is the ultimate symbol of our unity. Behind this icon have stood generations of athletes and coaches from all over BC, across the country, and around the world, who have chosen our university to pursue their passion. Champions, Olympians, legends. have made Burnaby Mountain their home.
This is it for the Grey Cup victory.
Basaglia's kick is up. It's good.
I had a dream that came into my head that one day I'd try and run across Canada.
I gotta set my goal at 5. Because I believe in miracles and I have to.
It doesn't get much better than perfect. SFU are your national champions.
Canada's first Olympic gold in women's wrestling.
Grounded in our strong, rich athletic history and united by the symbol of the SFU leaf, our athletes wear the SFU colors. Together, with pride. Every time we wear our leaf, we are inspired by that timeless sense of unity and harness that shared teamwork and determination to charge into the new season with a renewed sense of passion, inspiration, and commitment. We are the SFU Red Leafs. Welcome to our new era.
Dear College Sports,
there's light at the end of the tunnel.
A return to normal and all we love about sports.
You've instilled resilience, focus, and selflessness in us. We've put those lessons to work.
We've found strength and unity in each other.
You continue to take us places we never imagined.
You bring out the best in us.
So when we look forward, we see the light at the end of the tunnel.
We see a better world for all of us
and for college sports.
To build bridges.
I'm here to promote inclusion.
To embrace diversity.
To learn from others.
I'm here to support my community.
I'm here to lift people up.
To engage.
To listen.
I am here to grow.
Number 32, Kyle Hornsby.
The NCAA and its member schools offer nearly 500,000 college athletes a path to go pro in something other than sports. Learn more at NCAA.org.
I'm here to make a difference.
I'm here to create.
To innovate.
To do research that matters.
I am here to continue asking questions.
To continue learning.
To expand my horizons.
I am here to grow.
If I lose, I'll respond with respect.
If I win, I'll back it up with humility.
If I fail, I'll rise up with honor. It's tough for us to put it all on the line.
Don't undo my hard work with poor sportsmanship.
Respect. It's the name of the game.
I'm here to get more than a degree.
I'm here to explore.
To connect.
To learn.
I am here to forge a new path.
To push myself.
To set goals and achieve them.
I am here to win.
I am here to grow.
GNAC CCAA Challenge game, the third one of the tournament. This one between Western Washington and California State Dominguez Hills. And the Toros down 43-36 at the half, but will open the second half with possession. And a foul call against the Western Washington. We'll give you some of the leaders as we bring you the box score. And the leading scorer for Western Washington is Velt with 10 points, Ned with 9, and then over on the other side, 10 for Ball as well.
What?
Ball a 4 of 7 from the field, and now big block there by Coley. And a loose ball saved by Western Washington. Great job there by Minnis as he gets a helping hand from head coach Becker from the Toros. He steps back into the offensive side of the floor. And the ball is loose and tipped away out of bounds. Possession to the Toros as we are well underway now with some couple of trips down the floor, some exciting plays. Thank you for joining us on this broadcast. We hope you're having a good time enjoying the 2022-23 NCAA basketball season. First games for both yesterday night. Lob pass and the lay-in no good. Western Washington can't convert on that fast break. Now back the other way, and it's a lay-in for Cal State Dominguez Hills. Ball taking advantage and getting his team to within two possessions again at 43-38. Jump stop shot, and I believe that's going to be a foul call. So it looks like Seymour called for getting Coley on the head, because I think Seymour thought he got a clean block.
You're fine. Next play. Next play. Next play.
First foul shot on the way. That one just short for the Western Washington player, Coley. Redshirt freshman from Everett. Of course, lots of Washington guys. The Vikings always will have lots of local players on their roster. Second shot, no good. And the Toros escaping that possession. Doing relatively well there.
Did because like my friends wouldn't text me this, you know, for entertainment purposes.
Play stopped, but it will be a bucket and a foul for Western Washington.
No, I don't need shit. I don't really need shit no more. Like honestly. I'm just saying, like what do you want me to believe, bro? Do you not see when I get sent? Like, imagine you got that. Well, okay, how do you think I feel?
Foul shot good. So Western Washington up 46-38.
I don't accuse. I just look at what you've done. Because I've seen this before.
Nice layoff there for Cal State Dominguez Hills, and Hunter Seymour finishes with a big two-handed flush. His team back within two possessions, 46-40. Turnaround, tough shot there for Western Washington, but the rebound taken by Cauley, and he converts on the putback chance, the second chance opportunity, and makes it 48-40. And then I think Cauley on the other hand too, getting the block, and he has really kind of made his presence known here early in the second half as Johnson will leave the game. Looks like it will be Velp coming back in. He is now guarding the ball handler for Dominguez Hills. Cheatham, shot no good, rebound tipped into the air. Cheatham gets the ball back. Miller. Back up to the top of the circle. Hillstock off target. Rebound. Going to Western Washington. I think on first glance, I would say that should have been Toro's ball, but obviously the official, I believe that's Matt Goble on the far side, much closer to the play. And I think we're going to have some subs here. Western Washington Collie looking to hand off. Looking baseline, pass tipped away. Nice stop there by Watson. Berry. Back to his point guard, Miller.
Yeah.
Seymour looking to hand off. Cheatham being guarded closely there by Hornbuckle. Eight to shoot. Jumper just too strong. And Collie down with a rebound. Minnis, Collie.
I'll fucking believe it.
Covering a lot of space quickly. And he leans in, shot no good. Grabs his own loose ball and makes the put back to put Western Washington back up by double digits, 50 to 40. And that will cause the Toros to call a timeout here. Just 4 seconds after the 16-minute mark. So we will take a, I believe that will be turned into a media timeout. 50 to 40. And we're going to take a short break here. 15:56 to go in the second half. 50 to 40, Western Washington up on Cal State Dominguez Hills.
Number 32, Kyle Hornsby.
Inside the 30. Touchdown. Michaela Spurgeon.
An incredible finish by Hall.
The NCAA and its member schools offer nearly 500,000 college athletes a path to go pro in something other than sports. Learn more at NCAA.org.
I'm here to get more than a degree.
I'm here to explore.
To connect. To learn.
I am here to forge a new path.
To push myself.
To set goals and achieve them.
I am here to win.
I am here to grow.
Lots of oohs and ahs on that last play. Foul called on Western Washington. Watson will go to the line for two shots. Coach Becker wanting the goaltend. Western Washington contending that that was a clean block. And there Watson short on the first shot. And the second shot is good. So, again, the gap between the two teams within single digits. 50 to 41. Dominguez Hills looking to defend here and keep the Vikings from adding to that gap. Hornbuckle, handoff, baseline jumper, good. Nice old-fashioned baseline jumper there from Jonathan Ned, where number lucky number 13. That one along too. That one goes to Barry, converting that opportunity. Now back down the floor. The lay-in drops for Minnis. I think some of the Toros were saying that on the bench, saying that opportunity may be a bit too easy for Minnis to have gotten. Three-pointer off the mark, and then on the rebound, it will be a loose ball foul against Western Washington. Blue 11, that is going to be Holden, and I believe another timeout on the way. And just a reminder for those of you who maybe just want to watch more basketball, coming up next, Cal Poly Humboldt will play the host, Simon Fraser Red Leafs, here at the West Gym. We're going to take another break here. You're watching Cal State Dominguez Hills and Western Washington here on Red Leafs TV, and we'll be back after this short break. Offensive foul called on the Toros, the second one of the game, second personal foul of the game against Lowe. 6'7 sophomore from Murrieta, California. Minnis for Western Washington in navy blue. Holden baseline drive doesn't go, grabs the rebound and makes the putback and gives Western Washington a 56-43 lead. Toros finding ball down low. He can't make that shot. And now Holden slowed down in the backcourt. Will hand off to Minnis. Minnis being guarded by Miller. Top of the circle, three-point shot, no good from Velp. And now is going to be a foul on the ground. That shot does not count. Ball back into play. Andre, ball number three into the baseline for Seymour. Seymour looking to hand off. It's Dent Smith. 13 a shoot here in this offensive possession for CSUDH. Barry gets that shot to go. Nice drive on the left side. Velp ending up on the floor. I think he wanted a foul. There's looks like he got hit in the face. He's asking for foul on maybe a stray arm or elbow. And we are in a bit of a stoppage here as two of the officials are conversing. on the far side, at least far side from where I'm sitting. I'm sitting at the scorer's table. Camera, of course, on the other side. So Western will move the ball up the one sideline. Belp handing off. Jumper from the elbow, no good. And Dominguez Hills trying to force an opportunity short there on the lay-in. Offensive board, the putback finally drops for Seymour. So Dominguez Hills, I think, has just been fighting most of this game to kind of stay in it. They did take the lead earlier in the first half, but Western Washington, as you would imagine with such a good squad, was able to respond. Now Berry dribbles out of trouble. Three-point shot from the wing, no good. Holden with the rebound off that Dent Smith miss, and just a little bit of frustration there from Dent Smith. Like some of the officials and the coaches are really having some lively discussions and some heated comments thrown at each other between the coaches. So it may be early in the season, but the intensity has been brought by these two teams here, even north of the border, as that jump shot will fall for Minnis. And of course, Western Washington, no stranger, of course, to traveling above the 49th parallel. Western and Simon Fraser have been longtime rivals. First, of course, in the NAIA before SFU moved to the NCAA as well. So Western getting that block and will look to add to its 11-point lead, 58-47. Great play inside, and Cawley will be fouled. Morris, the play developing quickly as the pass into the low blocks forces the Dominguez Hills foul. It's a media timeout here. We're going to take a short break. Western Washington 58-47 over CSU Dominguez Hills. Western Washington's Cawley puts his team up 12, 59-47. Boston. And now it's 60-47. Western Washington ahead by double digits, but Dominguez Hills has been hanging around all game. They took the lead earlier in the first half, but couldn't extend it. And now block from behind. I believe the block was on by number one for Western Washington. That's Johnson, who is really a guy that gets involved all over the court here for Western. Now another stoppage in play. Barry getting a screen, going to his left, pulling up the jumper off the glass, no good. Rebound tipped out by Dominguez Hills. And now foul called as Cheatham has the ball knocked away from him. Morris had the ball and then found Cheatham. Cheatham on the line, 60-47. That time shot no good. Second shot is good. 11:04 to go before the end of regulation, and it is 60-48 in favor of Western Washington. Ball out of bounds on that play, and it will be Cal State Dominguez Hills ball. And just thought I'd give you some score updates for the Western Washington fans watching. They defeated Seattle Pacific 3-0 in women's volleyball today at SPU. And then, of course, the big game on campus was their regional game, the West regional game versus Point Loma, and they won 1-0. So they will survive and advance here in women's soccer in 2022. We'll give you some Toros updates in just a second as we will have a foul on the baseline in the corner. It's going to be Johnson once again. And another timeout, this time a full timeout, as we will take a break as well here at the West Gym. 60-48 in favor of Western Washington.
I'm here to make a difference.
I'm here to create.
To innovate.
To do research that matters.
I am here to continue asking questions.
To continue learning.
To expand my horizons.
I am here to grow.
Back in action, and it's a nice driving layup there by Cheatham. And again, we're back within 10 points. And just over a quarter of the game left to go. Hornbuckle laying no good, and he is knocked down to the ground with a foul. And Hornbuckle at the line is he gets some of his routine in. .61-50, the Vikings in the lead. I'm going to give you an update on some of the Dominguez Hills action. They lead Colorado School of Mines 1-0 in their men's soccer West Regional game as the inbounds pass thrown away, miscommunication between Cheatham and Barry, and that will give the Vikings a huge possession here. Also, non-conference basketball, Dominguez Hills leading at Concordia 81-66 as that shot makes Dominguez Hills pay. Western Washington, two quick possessions here with scores, and it's 64-50. Entering the final 10 minutes, Dominguez Hills obviously wanting to get the deficit within 10. Good start on that task there as the driving layup goes for Dent Smith. Johnson outside, and he makes the shot. He wants the foul too, I think, but nonetheless, it is a huge make for the Vikings. 67-52 with 9:23 to go in the second half. And not quite falling the same way for the Toros as that shot rolls out, but it will be an opportunity from the foul line for Cheatham. Leading scores in this game for the Toros. Ball and Barry both with 12 points. Cheatham now with 8. And then for Western Washington, it's Ned with 14 points. But a really balanced attack. Colley and Hornbuckle with 11. And then Velp with 10. And Velp and Holden with 7 rebounds each. And then over on the other side, Seymour and Ball with 5 each. But Miller has 7 assists for Dominguez Hills. And Hornbuckle has 5. Hornbuckle missing on that shot, and it's a one shot and done for Western Washington. Dent Smith just off target for that shot, and Johnson will reset here. Hornbuckle nearly has it knocked away, and it will be a foul on the floor. Two players on the floor. Oh, and it will be against Dominguez Hills. Hillstock was deemed as the person who made the infraction. Tough play there. Two guys just fighting for a loose ball. And the first shot from Hornbuckle is good. Someone yelling from the crowd, actually, I think, got one of the Toros players to maybe jump in early. It didn't matter on that play. Second shot is good. It's Western Washington ahead by a score of 69-54. Pass across, and it's saved by Dominguez Hills. Nice play there by Hillstock. And ball worked inside. Barry cutting to the hoop, open, and makes the lay-in. Both teams in the bonus as it is a 69-56 game. And then now an offensive foul on Western Washington. And it looks like Ned will be called for the foul. And I believe that was Dent Smith taking the charge. And I don't think the Toros really care who takes the charge. They get the ball back, 69-56. And that is certainly one of the plays that will always get the team going. The guy stepping in on defense and making a sacrifice and a big play to get the ball back. 8 minutes to go. Three-pointer on the way, Dent Smith. Looked like it was on target, but the distance obviously a bit off. Ned getting the rebound and over to his teammate. And now worked around the horn here. And I believe two players getting to the blocks to try to get to the pass. And it will be a foul on Miller. So we're going to take another media timeout, and we are going to take a break as well here on Red Leafs TV. Western Washington ahead 69-56 over Cal State Dominguez Hills. To make that 71-58. Dominguez Hills back within 13. They have fought so hard this whole game to stay with the Vikings, but this is a very, very strong Western Washington squad. Step back jumper, leaning backwards, no good, and the rebound out of bounds. Team possession in favor of Cal State Dominguez Hills. Miller, entry pass taken away by Johnson, spins past Miller, pass to Holden. Holden looking to get rid of the ball, finds Velp at the elbow. Great patience here by the Vikings, no need to force things as they do have a workable, comfortable lead. Lob pass for Velp underneath the hoop, stepping back and will draw the foul. First shot from Velp is good. It's another nice performance here from Velp. He's got 11 points, 7 rebounds. I think that's 12 points now as we catch up with the live stats here. As the minutes wind down, jump shot strong, and rebound knocked out of bounds by Western Washington. And a few more subs coming in for Cal State Dominguez Hills. Berry. Seymour. And then now a foul on that, pardon me, I believe that was a kick ball. Do apologize. There are a couple of people who get really animated and step kind of right out front of us. And now on that lob play, ball will draw the foul. And Western Washington coach Dominguez unhappy, and now I think that part of it was that Ned fouled out, and Velp will come back in. So ball is at the foul line. And both shots are good, and it's a 73-59 game. Johnson now over to Holden. Colley. And now foul called on Dominguez Hills. Miller on the right wing from where I am at the scores table on the right wing. And now that is going to be 4 fouls, and a lot of frustration being expressed by head coach Eric Becker here for Dominguez Hills. Pardon me, Steve Becker. Apologize, I believe Eric Becker is a photographer with Western Washington. So I apologize for that, just getting a few of the familiar names and faces mixed up here. The shot is good, it's 75-59. Quick 3 on the way, no good, rebound taken back by Dominguez Hills, ball. Nice feed inside, and it's an uncontested lay-in for Cheatham. Johnson responds with an and-one play as he makes that bucket on the baseline drive. Johnson looking to complete the 3-point play, and that one goes down. 78-61 Western Washington. You have to give credit to the Vikings. They have definitely held this Toros team in check, not really allowed them to build a lot of momentum and a big run or two, and there again forcing a shot that maybe they did the Toros didn't want to take. Ball worked inside, intercepted. Great play there by Barry, although I think Western Washington coach Dominguez really wanted a foul. Ball just in from the three-point line. Uncontested rebound for Johnson. And now another stoppage in play, and it will be a foul against Dominguez Hills. That will be, well, they've passed the 10 foul mark. Second foul on Barry. Second chance, strong, but it gets the nice bounce. So Western Washington now up by 19 points. Ball worked down low, and the turnaround shot no good there from Seymour, and then now a ball out of bounds, possession to Western Washington. Belt. Johnson for the Vikings. Working against Barry, turnaround shot. And that one gets the bounce, and Johnson delivers a little bit of a smile back to the Western bench. And now stoppage in play. Full timeout, Dominguez Hills. We're going to take a timeout here as well. 3:37 left in regulation, Western 82, CSU Dominguez Hills 61. It looks like we are kind of winding down this game here. It looks like Western will leave with a pretty comfortable victory and go undefeated here, barring a big comeback from Dominguez Hills. But the Toros just really haven't been able to get a lot of flow going and get a bit of momentum and build some one or two big runs here. And they're now down 82-63. Johnson for Western. Now Colley will draw the foul. Looks like that'll be the fifth and disqualifying foul for Ball. And will be Hillstock coming back in. Second shot, no good, and the loose ball taken by Seymour. Seymour missing. Loose ball, rebound, put back by Cheatham. '83-'65, Western in the lead, and looks like they'll just milk the clock here and run out the weekend for them as a three-pointer from Hornbuckle makes it 86-65. Now a 21-point lead, and I believe this is the first time the lead has gone above 20. Ball entered into play. Barry right through the paint, cutting and weaving all the way from the perimeter to the bucket for two. Nice acrobatic, athletic play by Barry. Jumper, long distance. That is going to be a long two by Western Washington. And I believe the call will be Western ball. And it will be another timeout here with Western Washington ahead, 88-67. Looks like they will go into the second week of the season with an undefeated 2-0 record here after beating Cal Poly Humboldt yesterday. And we're just going to stay through the break here. Three-pointer from Hornbuckle, and I think coming in late, Western Washington will make the scoreline, I think, much wider in terms of a difference than maybe how this game has felt the whole way. Jumper on the way, three ball goes down for Western Washington. It's Wyatt Watson, junior and a transfer from the University of Portland. Back the other way, shot no good, and we are still gonna fight hard here if you're the Toros. And the ball out of bounds, Miller diving to get the loose ball, but then throwing the ball away, unfortunately. top of the arc. Three ball, no good. Rebound, likely last one possession here. Quick attempt there from the top of the half circle, no good for Dominguez Hills Hillstock. So we will get a few more, possibly. Yeah, a few more possessions here, maybe one more. Looks like Jordan DeBoer will run it out along with D'Angelo Minnis. We are going to wrap this one up as Western Washington completes a perfect weekend here in Burnaby. The Vikings defeat both Cal Poly Humboldt and Cal State Dominguez Hills 94-69. As we will wrap up this game, and thank you very much for joining us here on this broadcast. And we will be back with the next game, Cal Poly Humboldt and Simon Fraser here from Burnaby, BC. Thanks again, and have a great rest of your weekend, and we'll see you on the court somewhere next weekend. Good luck to the rest of the, for these teams, to these teams for the rest of the season as well.